I recently bought the Fuji X100, the original one, because I wanted to fall in love again with the idea of street photography. And I say again because I've been a long time user of the Sony full frame system, having had the A7R, the R2, the one I'm using right now, the R3, with different Sony, Tamron, and Sigma lenses. I've been asking myself this question over the years: am I a photographer or a content creator? Do I capture images that make me feel something, or do I intentionally recreate that emotion in my images? We don't know what makes a picture great. Perhaps there's a level of imperfection or oddity in images we choose to look at. For example, what do you see in this picture? Do you see what is shown in the foreground, or what is shown in the reflection? Over the last year, I've been spending more and more time in the studio for obvious reasons, and the more I shot, the more I learned about my style and where I wanted to go from here. We all have good and bad days when it comes to creativity. The pictures we take might not be perfect, or at least the way we understand perfection, but our favorite images and movies have a few things in common. They're strange, and they stir up feelings and emotions in us. I've actually struggled with this in the past, and I think imperfection is challenging the way we think about things in general, not just photography. We have to remember that photography is not reality, and good or bad photography is highly subjective. Now, for me, a good photograph is something that takes me back to the place where it was taken, like a song or a smell. It's something really personal. People don't see the bokeh of cinema lenses. We don't see time lapses. We don't see light trails. So it's not what an image looks like that really matters. It's what makes you feel inside when you see it. This is not a video about Sony or Fuji, but about my journey from a full frame system that I only use in the studio now to a smaller, older camera that is just more fun. I am by no means a street photographer. I always took pictures with the Sonys I've had over the years, but the idea of street photography is more appealing with something like this compared to carrying around heavy equipment I usually use for filming, something like the A7R III rigged out with a V-mount on it. This is easier, it's more fun, and I dare to say it looks better. When it comes to street photography, the way I use the Sony versus the way I use the Fuji is very different. I use the Sony like I'm in the studio. The images look clean and the edit is more elaborate. I go from a normal image to a composition. things are not the same with the Fuji. I treat the Fuji almost like a film camera. I don't do a lot of editing. I just use some presets that I've been working on over the years. In this case, something similar to the Kodachrome. The edit is also subjective. There is no right exposure, but a matter of opinion. I usually use the right exposure that gets me where I want to go, that lets me create the feeling I want. We each have our own different styles that we developed over the years of taking pictures or shooting video, but that style is not complete. And I do believe in a few years from now, changes will occur because you keep developing as a human being and also a photographer. So your style will change because you will change.